Here at T&O in Petten, we have setups that we use for SEWGS and SEDMES development. Let me show you how they work. T&O is active in national and international programs with industry and science to work on technologies to capture and convert carbon dioxide. The biggest challenge for steel, refinery and chemical industries nowadays is to reduce the CO2 emissions while they're still dependent on fossil fuels. Two technologies have been developed. One is called sorption-enhanced water gas shift, or SEWGS in short, which is a technology where we can capture the CO2 from industrial streams. The second technology, sorption-enhanced DME synthesis, or SEDMES, has been developed to convert carbon dioxide into a very useful product, dimethyl ether, or DME. These technologies are cost-effective in reducing carbon dioxide emissions and thereby contribute to achieving the 2050 climate targets. In the north of Sweden, at our partner institute, Sverim, we have a large-scale SEWGS setup where we can work with actual steel gas and we can show that the technology is robust. Hydrotelluride is a chemically very robust material because SEWGS operates at 400 degrees centigrade typically and pressures between 20 and 30 bars using high concentrations of steam. Now the SEWGS material is saturated with CO2, and once the material is saturated we go into a regeneration phase where we flush the material with steam and CO2 is removed from the material again. By cycling, we can create a continuous process to remove CO2 from a fuel gas stream.
So sorption-enhanced dimethyl ether synthesis, or SEDMES, is a novel technology for the direct conversion of CO2 to dimethyl ether. Dimethyl ether is an alternative fuel or platform chemical. Mm-hmm. And recently, we've demonstrated SEDMES at the multi-column test rig here at T&O in Petten. We've achieved up to 95% conversion of CO2 to dimethyl ether, and we've shown to be able to regenerate the system with a PSA, so a pressure swing regeneration cycle only, which would allow for faster cycle times and enhanced productivity. Both allow us to scale up the system rapidly.
Dit is de SEWGS 1 reactor. Hij is 2 meter lang, ongeveer inhoud van 2 liter. We vullen de reactor in het geval van SEWGS. Vullen we de reactor met dit soort pellets, hydrotalcit. We voeden vanaf de top voeden we een gasmengsel met CO2. Wanneer CO2 geabsorbeerd wordt, komt er energie vrij. En we hebben overal in de reactor thermokoppels zitten. Dan kunnen we de temperatuur in het bed volgen. Dus we zien precies wanneer het hele bed verzadigd is met CO2. Dan gaan we de stroomrichting omdraaien. We voeden stoom van onder. En dat stoom dat zorgt ervoor dat dat CO2 weer uit die pellets geduwd wordt. En we houden een CO2-rijk mengsel open.
Dit is de SEWGS 7. Het is een multi-column system. Like the SEWGS 1 is a single column for batch processes. Mm-hmm. And here in the multi-column system, we can make a continuous power process. So once it's one column is in feed, and another two columns are pressure equalization system. The third one is in cleaning mode, in rinse mode or in purge mode. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So in that way, we can use it in a continuously way. From this year on, we use the SEWGS 7 not only for CO2 separation, mm-hmm. But also to make high caloric, high value fuels out of it. This is the hydrotalcite, so that's the material for CO2 separation, right, like a sponge for CO2. Mm-hmm. And if you add some extra material, some catalyst or other components, and then you can create the reaction to make those high valuable fuels.
In the coming years, we will work to further scale up SEWGS technology. The plan is to demonstrate SEWGS in a multi-column unit connected to the steel industry. And for SEDMES, we will do field testing in the Rotterdam Field Lab for industrial electrification. Are you interested in the background of SEWGS and SEDMES technologies? Or are you interested to see applications of SEWGS and SEDMES technologies? Visit us at www.tno.nl.